Behind me is the 2016 Ford Edge. Now, the Edge was introduced recently as an all-new model, and it only gets some minor updates this year. It's a pretty powerful model. All-wheel drive is available, front drive is normal, and the Edge itself is, you know, kind of your mid-size SUV. This also serves as a foundation as the Lincoln MKX. Edmunds gave this vehicle an A rating because of its ride quality, because of the steering, and because of the power out of the optional engines. This can be very fast and a very nice car to drive. The sizing is good. We'll show you a lot more of the interior too and some of the updates that they've done inside. But as you can see, generally the design is appealing, and so are these taillights back here. They really give the Edge a nice look overall. This is a titanium model, so it gets some additional trim and some nice upgrades on it too. And let's take a look inside. So inside this 2016 Edge, there's a couple things that stick out to you. Probably noticeably this gauge cluster with a giant center analog speedometer, and then also these displays here, which when the car's on will show you different things. A lot of space to show you information, which is really nice. The design too is pleasant. It looks very modern in here with decent materials. These seats have leather on, which feel really nice. This piano black trim stuff attracts fingerprints and whatnot, so that could look worn pretty quickly. This is the old version of Ford's infotainment system. This is my Ford Touch. They're replacing it throughout the Ford line and Lincoln's for the next few years with a system called Sync 3, which in our experience looks to be a lot faster and a lot more streamlined than this interface that it has here. Future models will not have this anymore. It'll be a different thing entirely. But down here, the center stack is attractive and easy to use with nice feeling buttons and stuff, heated and cooled seats on this model. And there's your storage tray right there with two USB ports for powering your devices, which is helpful. And also an SD card and a line and auxiliary input right there as well. Your storage compartments continue down here with another 12-volt power outlet right there, and a pretty deep cargo capacity too. And it's actually pretty bright in here, because if you look up, you'll notice this has a large panoramic sunroof, which is very nice for giving light to the passengers in the back as well as the front. Speaking of, let's take a look inside the back. Take one last look at the front, and then we'll go to the back. What's nice too is these large rear doors make it pretty easy to get in and out. Ingress and egress in this car is fairly easy, and the space is good too. I'm 5'10", and my knees don't hit the seat in front of me at all. My hair is just brushing the roof, because this sunroof, does take away a bit of headroom. But overall space back here is pretty good. You have seat heaters, another 12-volt power outlet, and a three-prong plug down here too, which is really nice. With all the devices and stuff people have when they sit inside these cars, it's really nice to be able to plug all this stuff in. And that's a look inside the Ford Edge. To find out more about the Ford Edge and find out why it received an A rating from Edmunds, go to edmunds.com.